So to begin with, there are quite a few words used like sedimentation, settling, or clarification. So in water treatment or in even in the wastewater treatment aspects, these all meant about basically a unit where we tend to do the phase separation process in order to settle out the suspended materials. So the water coming in or the wastewater coming in for that matter may have several suspended particles, and what we tend to achieve through putting them to a sedimentation unit or settling basin is removal of majority of those settleable materials like clay, silt, organic matter, or various other associated impurities, and the settlement takes place under the effect of gravity. So we may have suspended materials which are particles originally present in the source water like clay and silts. So for them we go for plain settling or primary sedimentation, what we call. We may tend to settle at times flocks, so we may go for coagulation flocculation first and then go for settling process. So that is basically the coagulant assisted settling or chemical settling, okay, chemical added settling. And we may at times need to settle the biomass, which is more applicable to the wastewater treatment and not for the water treatment. So this is actually for wastewater treatment when we have secondary settling where we try to settle the biomass. But generally for water treatment aspects, in most cases we go for coagulant assisted settling, means we do settling after coagulation flocculation process. But at times if water is too turbid, we may go for the primary or plain settling as well. Now how we achieve settling? We achieve settling by decreasing the velocity of water. So if we have any unit and water is, say, nothing settles in the pipe because water is flowing through substantial velocity. So velocity is enough to keep the suspended materials in the suspension, no settling will happen. When we put that in a tank, the velocity is reduced, and then although there will be some horizontal velocity component, but then there is a, by virtue of gravity, there is a pull from bottom or pull towards like downward direction. So the resultant direction of the flow becomes somewhere like this, and then it can hit the bottom and settle out. So the settling is achieved by decreasing the velocity of water to a point below which it will not support the transport of particle. And by gravity, the particle will actually be settling at the bottom and will be removed. So there are four different types of settling. The type one settling, which is also known as discrete settling or free settling, is when a particle is settling without kind of getting into interaction with any other particle. So one particle is settling on its own. It is not affected by another particle. Okay, so that is the most kind of ideal case. It's a particle is settling free from the effect or interaction of the other particles. So normally at the top, the particles are kind of free, they are individual and they settle by their own. But once they are settling in the in between somewhere where the particle density increases, they get an opportunity to interact with each other. Okay. So then they will move to the type 2 settling, which is flocculant settling zone. Okay. So in flocculant settling or type 2 settling, basically the particle initially settle independently, as we said, but then they will flocculate in depth in the clarification unit. So instead of settling as a single particle, they will settle as a flock, as a larger mass. And because this is the aggregate has a larger mass, so the settling velocity will also be higher in the case. Okay, so flocculant particle or the settling velocity in the flocculant settling is higher typically than the discrete settling. Now, the type 3 settling, which is also known as hindered settling or zone settling, is basically when particles settle as a mass, settle as a complete zone, but there are intra-particle forces which kind of keep those particles apart. So if I have one particle here, another particle here, another particle here, another particle here, so all will settle together, but they are not getting accumulated. It's not like they will club like this. That doesn't happen. So these particles will settle as a mass kind of, but their intraparticle forces will basically be keep on acting. And these forces then hinder the settling. And that's why it is known as hindered settling. They settle as a zone. So that's why it is also known as zone settling. But in the zone settling cases, the intraparticle forces will hinder the settling of the neighboring particles. And that's why the settling slows down. So velocity of the settling or settling velocity here is going to be lower as opposed to the free settling or flocculent settling. And then the last, which is type 4 settling, is basically the compression settling, so which occurs towards the bottom of the tank, okay, when there is a sufficient high load at the top. Okay, so because of this high weight, the particles are mechanically influenced and they get compressed. So the settling achieved because of this compression of the particle is known as the compression settling, and the settling velocity will be drastically low here. So if we see in the settling velocity, this one will have the kind of highest settling velocity, and then this will be kind of second highest. So this one will be the highest, this one will be the second highest. Zone settling will be third, and compression settling has the least velocity. Okay. So this is the different type of settling, four different type of settling that we typically see in the sedimentation process. Now, if we see the different type of sedimentation basin, so there are two types, intermittent and continuous types. The intermittent types are also kind of batch type. So they are quiescent type tank. Water is filled. It completely remains static. The particles which has to be settled will be settled, and then water will be taken out, okay, after a certain period. The more common is actually the continuous flow type settling tank, where the water will be coming from one side and leaving from the other side, but as discussed, the velocity will be very low, and it actually kind of gives the removal of the suspended materials or suspended particle. So it will never be brought to complete rest. Okay. From geometry perspective, there are two types of tank which are usually in practice: the rectangular settling tanks and circular settling tanks. So rectangular settling tanks are basins which are long rectangular kind, or circular basins are which are circular in the plan. Okay. Long rectangular tanks with kind of horizontal flow are generally preferred to circular tanks with radial or spiral flow. But economy-wise, circular tank may actually prove the better solution at times. So circular tanks are also quite popular. Now, in the process of settling, any settling basin will typically have four different zones. Okay. So these zones are the inlet zone, the first one. So either it's a rectangular settling tank or it's a circular settling tank. What happens, water will be entering at some point in the tank. So let's say if water is entering from this point, where water enters, there will be some initial turbulence over here. So this particular zone is known as inlet zone. Okay. The role of inlet zone is to provide a smooth transition of water and distribute water uniformly across the tank, okay, across the inlet of the tank. So generally a baffle will be provided, and through these baffles water will enter at the different zones. It's not that all water is entering from here, because in that case, if all water is entering here, there is large chances of short circuiting, and then water entering here may directly flow out there. So in order to avoid that, we generally provide baffle and so that water enters at different levels through the inlet point. So the role of inlet is to gently spread the flow across the inlet and prevent any kind of short circuiting. In rectangular settling basins, we'll have zone where the water is entering. In circular also, water enters basically in the center. So the inlet zone is usually in the center. So like if this is my inlet pipe, water will enter here and then it will be basically, we'll provide some sort of mechanism in order to reduce the turbulence over here, and this becomes my inlet zone in circular tanks. Next is settling zone, which is the most important part of a settling basin. Ideally, when we design, when we go for designing a settling basin, we target this zone particularly. So settling zone is where water is coming from the inlet, and then the settlement process typically takes place. So this is the zone where sedimentation will take place. In rectangular, majority of the tank part is actually settling zone. In circular again, so after inlet, all round the water is basically in the settling zone. So as you can see, the settling zone is, all these portions are in the settling zone. Then there is a sludge zone. So the mass which settles down, the sediments which settle down are typically known as sludge. Okay, so the tank has to provide a storage area for the sludge before the sludge is taken out. Okay, before the sludge is removed by a scraper or any vacuum device. So flow velocity near the sludge zone should be minimized so that sludge doesn't come into the suspension. So the bottom portion will actually be sludge zone. So in case of say rectangular tank, this is your sludge zone, and in case of circular tank also the sludge zone will be at the bottom. So as you can see, this is the sludge zone. The last one is the outlet zone, which has a responsibility to provide a smooth transition from the settling zone to the effluent channel or outlet channel or outlet pipe. Okay. This also basically controls the level of water in the tank. Okay, to what level the water will be there in the tank, that is also controlled by this outlet basin. So outlet basin is typically in the form of weirs at the end, which kind of controls the flow. So we can have a weir like this and water can enter through these weirs and it can be taken out. So this zone is known as outlet zone. And in the circular tank, towards the periphery, throughout all the periphery, we'll have basically weir from water will be flowing towards these, and these are known as then the outlet zone.
So now in this video, you have seen the theoretical part, some theoretical part, that is, first of all, it was shown that various sedimentation tanks, for example, when you are talking about plain sedimentation tank without any addition of any chemicals or coagulants, that was plain sedimentation tank. Then you have sedimentation with coagulation when coagulants are added into the sedimentation tank. And you have secondary sedimentation tank, which I did not take the name because that is not the part of this, of the environment engineering one. It is related to your wastewater. So when you study the sewage treatment plant, that time you have the secondary sedimentation tank. Okay, so these are the three sedimentation tanks. Then in the video, it was shown that there are different types of settling, right? Type 1 settling, that is free settling of the particles. Type 2 settling, when actually the particles form flocks. Even when the coagulants are added, the impurities get attached to the coagulants and form larger size particles. So that larger size particle is called the flocks. Even the particles can come together and form a larger particle within themselves. So that is also called the flock. So if they are combining together and forming flocks, and then because of the increase in the mass, they are settling down, then that is your type 2, which is called the flocculent settling. Type 3 is the hindered settling, when there is hindrance in the settling velocity because of the intermolecular forces of the individual impurity. And then you have the type 4 settling. That is, if there is any compression force, compression settling. And because of that, if the particles are settling down, so that is your compression settling. Then you had types of sedimentation tank. It can be called as a sedimentation tank, sedimentation basin, settling basin, clarifier. All the names have the same meaning. Okay. Then you had types of sedimentation tank discussed. That is, depending, jaise maine tumko bola tha ki, if the water is kept stable, kept stand at a particular place, that is called the intermittent settling. Intermittent matlab, for some period you are supposed to keep it standalone. Then you are supposed to release it. Again, you are supposed to fill it and then keep it for some time and then again release. So that is an intermediate, continuous procedure. Nahi hai na. Ruka rahe and fir usko fir flow kara rahe. So that is why it is called as the intermittent sedimentation tank or intermittent settling basin. And then you have, which is now not used, the intermittent one is not, you will not see it anywhere mostly, because that is not possible because you don't have a continuous flow of water. So then you have the continuous flow settling basin, wherein the water is made to flow continuously with lower velocity. Then according to the geometry, again the sedimentation tanks are divided as shown, that is rectangular and circular sedimentation tanks, right? So rectangular in the sense from inlet to outlet, jaise maine bola tha, inlet to outlet the water is made to flow, and as they have also shown in the video that baffle walls are provided in order to obstruct the flow of water and reduce the velocity. Either that is the process, or you have this circular sedimentation tank. If you have now seen the video, in that they have shown that water enters from the center of the sedimentation tank, circular, and then spreads all over the area. Okay, so that is, it spreads from the center to the surrounding area in the circular sedimentation tank. Okay, and plus one more point they have shown, that when waters go for example, in the circular sedimentation tank, when water enters from the central pipe system and keeps filling the area of the sedimentation tank slowly, so when it overflows, it gets dispersed into the outlet. And outlet mein jaane ke time, there are weirs provided. Now, weirs kya hai, ye tumko pata hai. So, weirs are provided for water to go through that outlet surrounding the circumference of the circular sedimentation tank. So that also a point was mentioned about providing weirs for water to pass through the outlet, you could say, or an outlet chamber. Okay. Then according to the process happening inside the settling basin, there are zones provided in the settling basin, right? So it was shown that there are inlet zone, settling zone, sludge zone and outlet zone, right? Inlet, outlet, you understand. Sludge is the particles that will settle down at the bottom, get deposited at the bottom of the tank. That particles are called as the sludge, or that layer of the particles is called the sludge. Okay, so that's sludge zone, and the process where the settling happens, that is called the settling zone. Okay, few more things you are supposed to learn about this sedimentation tank. Just give me a minute.
Ma'am, voice is not audible.
Are you able to hear my voice properly? Okay, then wait a minute.
So if we consider these assumptions, then what we can see that for any particle of dyad, which is kind of just getting removed, flow is laminar. In ideal conditions, if we talk about the ideal settling of discrete particle, so what happens when a particle enters in the tank, okay, it will be under the like different forces. So it will have some horizontal velocity and it will have some vertical velocity. Okay. If we take certain assumptions under ideal conditions, say like flow is laminar, the particle is evenly distributed in the tank, the entrance and exit of the tank are not affecting the removal efficiency or sedimentation efficiency, and whatever particle has settled, has come to the sludge zone, is not getting resuspended. So if we consider these assumptions, then what we can see that for any particle of dyad, which is kind of just getting removed here, okay, the settling velocity of that particle is going to be equal to, because say if a particle is entering here, you consider that if you are talking about particle of just one sizes, so one particle is entering here and another particle is entering here, so they will be under similar forces. So if this is the trajectory of the particle, this will be the trajectory of this particle. Okay. So this particle will certainly get removed. If we want to remove all particles of this size, we have to consider that whichever is entering at the top in the tank should also get removed. Okay. Whichever is entering in the lower positions will automatically get removed if the particle diameter is of the similar size. But the one that is entering at the top should be removed, that should be our target. So if the tank height, if tank height means the effective height of the settling basin, okay, of this settling zone, okay, tank height doesn't mean the entire tank height, we keep some freeboard, we keep some provision for sludge zone also, but here because we are talking about the settling process, so that means we are specifically focusing on the settling zone. So if the height of the settling zone is say h, okay, then and the particle removes t time in the tank, because we know that some discharge is going on q, and then there is it is leaving the system, so it is spending some time depending on the volume of this settling zone. So we can get t as basically volume by discharge. Okay, so the this is the time that the particles are spending in the your settling zone, okay, and they should be removed in this time. And how they will remove? They will remove only if they strike the sludge zone somewhere and does not fall into the outlet zone. Because in assumption, if any particle is going into the outlet zone, we consider that particle not to be settled and will actually move with the effluent. So technically, in order to particle getting settled, we want the particle to come into the sludge zone. And how it will come into the sludge zone? Only if it can cover this h distance in the t time. If particle is spending t time in the tank, so in this t time, in this particularly t time, it has to cover this h distance. So what has to be the settling velocity of the particle? Settling velocity of the particle has to be h by t. This is the minimum settling velocity of the particle that is needed for particle of this particular dia to get removed. Okay. Now, as we just discussed that your T is V by Q, so we get H by V by Q or HQ by V, right? So volume is length into width into height of this particular basin, this particular zone, and then height gets cancelled and we get Q by L into B, which is basically the plan area of the tank. So the settling velocity has effectively equal to the discharge divided by the plan area. And this is known as surface overflow rate. Okay, so surface overflow rate means per unit surface area, how much discharge is being provided. Okay, and that that our settling velocity has to be equal to this surface overflow rate or higher than surface overflow rate in order to particle of that diameter should have 100% removal. So the surface overflow rate is typically the volume of water flowing in a unit time per unit surface area of the settling basin. Okay, this is also known as overflow rate, and the unit is actually meter cube, which is discharge meter cube per second, and per unit area. So meter cube per meter square per second, or meter cube per second per meter square. Per second per meter square, whichever way we want to express. So this is unit, which eventually turns out to be meter per second, okay, or meter per hour, whichever unit we take, means the length per unit time. So it will come to that level, but while expressing, we don't express it as meter per second, rather we more commonly express it as meter cube per meter square per second, or meter cube per second per meter square, because here we are talking, it should be basically clearly so that we are not talking about the velocity, it's more of a like discharge loaded per unit surface area. Okay, and that's why we go for this kind of units.
So I think I'm audible properly, right? Okay. So in this particular section, what I've shown, I'm not showing you the whole video because I just wanted to give the brief idea whatever is there in your syllabus. Okay. Because this is when you see the NPTEL videos, they are very much in depth. Of course, you can go through them, but we are now covering into what are things are there in our syllabus. So you must have understood this thing, that is in this previous thing, he has shown that the chamber, or you can say the basin, is divided into zones, that is inlet zone, outlet zone, settling zone, this is this part, and the sludge zone, right? So this is the length and this is the height of the water, what you can say, the water inside the sedimentation time without considering the sludge zone. Okay, because every time now when we are designing a sedimentation tank also, designing matlab kya, for example, if it is rectangle, LBH, brother, or for example, if it is this thing, the circular, then what we have to know is the diameter and the height, brother. The height to sabke isme aata hi hai, be it rectangular or be it the circular. So height actually kya nikalte hain hum log, so height is actually the water height. Okay, kyunki hum water ka jo volume hai, ओके वाटर का जो क्वांटिटी है उससे उससे हम लोग ये डायमेंशंस निकालते हैं. तो अगर वाटर के क्वांटिटी से हम अगर डायमेंशंस निकालने वाले हैं टैंक का, तो वाटर का जो डेप्थ होगा वो हमको मिलेगा डायमेंशन में एज हाइट ऑफ द वाटर, हाइट ऑफ द टैंक, राइट. सो इसीलिए जो एच है ना, ये हाइट ऑफ टैंक नहीं बोलते बट साइड वाटर डेप्थ यू कैन से बेसिकली. ओके, and then when you are supposed to give the actual dimensions of the tank, फिर उसमें स्लज जोन थोड़ा सा से 0.5 मीटर उतना ऐड करते हैं, फिर उसमें फ्री बोर्ड ऐड करते हैं. ओके, बट एक्चुअली व्हेन यू कैलकुलेट द डाइमेंशंस फ्रॉम द क्वांटिटी ऑफ वाटर, दैट एच इज नथिंग बट द साइड वाटर डेप्थ, और इसलिए यहाँ पे जो है वो स्लज जोन कंसिडर नहीं किया है, ठीक है. एंड देन व्हाट दे हैव शोन इन दिस, इफ यू गो थ्रू दिस you know diagram, what they have shown is for any particle entering into the sedimentation tank, now not necessary ki particle sirf upar se hi enter hoga, upar matlab to extreme hai, barabar iske upar to pani nahi hai na, to ye to matlab maximum height hai ki jahan se particle enter ho sakta hai sedimentation tank mein. Okay, isse kam height mein enter kiya to settle hoga hi, barabar, lekin maximum height se jab settle ho raha hai तो उसको सेटल होने के लिए इट हैज टू कवर दिस होल डिस्टेंस एंड सेटल डाउन एंड दिस इज द एक्सट्रीम सेटलिंग, मतलब मैक्सिमम यहाँ तक पहुंच के वो सेटल हो सकता है. इसके आगे अगर गया देन इट विल गो टू द आउटलेट जोन, वो सेटल नहीं होगा. इसका मतलब उसका वेलोसिटी भी इतना ज्यादा था कि वो मतलब पहुंचने तक सेटल ही नहीं हुआ, आउटलेट जोन में चला गया. इट इज लाइक दैट. हैज एनीवन अनम्यूटेड? Okay, so it means like that. And when you are talking about types of velocity, you have flow velocity and you have settling velocity. Okay, flow velocity matlab kya? जिस वेलोसिटी से द वॉटर इज फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम इनलेट टू आउटलेट, जैसे हम बोलते हैं ना वेलोसिटी उसका कम होना चाहिए सो दैट द अमाउंट ऑफ पार्टिकल्स, मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ पार्टिकल्स शुड गेट सेटल डाउन, राइट? सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द फ्लो वेलोसिटी. फिर सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी क्या है? सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स. सो ये डिफरेंस है. फ्लो वेलोसिटी जब हम बोलते हैं इट इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ द वॉटर, एंड सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ सेटलिंग ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स. ओके, so there are two velocities, flow velocities and settling velocity. Okay, now flow velocity is mostly indicated by only v, okay, and settling velocity is indicated by vs if you see here. Okay, aur fir yahan pe unhone dikhaya ki that vs is nothing but the time taken by the velocity of the particles to settle down, and that will be distance upon time. Which distance? So this h, that is time taken to cover this h distance. So h by t, that is nothing but the velocity, that is the settling velocity of the particles. And that settling velocity, then we can again convert it. See what we have done, that is h by t, or t ko hum v by q bhi likh sakte, volume upon the discharge, meter cube upon meter cube per second. Okay, so that also gives you the duration, time. Okay, and then if you will divide this, that is this q, अगर हम ऊपर लेते हैं and v as l v and h, and then what we get is q upon l into v, and l into v is nothing but the area. Now ये area कौन सा area? जब हम l into v बोलते हैं ना, जब यहाँ पे h दिख रहा है, पे v नहीं दिख रहा है, l into v will be the width. Okay, so that is called the plane area, या फिर उसको surface area भी बोलते हैं. Surface है ना, सर्फेस सेडिमेंटेशन टैंक का. सो आइदर इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ए प्लेन एरिया और द सर्फेस एरिया. इसलिए बहुत जगह पे तुमको यहाँ पे ए एस भी दिखेगा बुक्स वगैरह में ना, क्यू अपॉन ए एस भी लिखते हैं. ए एस इज नथिंग बट द सर्फेस एरिया. ओके, नाउ एरिया को ऐसा डिवाइड क्यों किया है? बिकॉज हम जब टैंक का बात करते हैं तो देर आर टू एरियाज. वन इज द सर्फेस एरिया विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द प्लेन एरिया, एंड द अदर इज द क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया. When particles are moving, okay, from this inlet to outlet, cross section area matlab kya hoga? It would be b into h, right? That will be the cross section area. H ye wala aur b, that is width. Okay, so that will be the cross section area. Okay, particle is moving through this cross section area. Okay, so jaise humne yahan pe vs settling velocity q upon a likha hai. बराबर, दैट इज क्यू अपॉन सरफेस एरिया. वैसे ही मुझे अगर फ्लो वेलोसिटी ऐसे टर्म में लिखना होगा तो मैं क्या लिखूंगी? फ्लो वेलोसिटी वी विल बी इक्वल टू क्यू डिस्चार्ज, लेकिन एरिया विल बी द क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया. दैट इज जहां पे, यहाँ पे एल इंटू बी है, वहां पे क्या होगा? बी इंटू एच. ओके, दैट इज इट इज मूविंग थ्रू दिस एरिया. और सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी मतलब पार्टिकल्स आर सेटलिंग एट दिस सरफेस एरिया. ओके, सो सरफेस एरिया इज नथिंग बट एल इन टू बी, ऑल्सो एक्सप्रेस एज ए एस. ओके, सो यू सी हियर नाउ दैट हाउ वी गेट द सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी एज क्यू अपॉन ए. नाउ देयर इज वन मोर टर्म विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज दिस सरफेस ओवरफ्लो रेट, या फिर जैसे यहाँ पे लिखा है ना सरफेस ओवरफ्लो रेट और ओवरफ्लो रेट, या सरफेस लोडिंग रेट भी बोलते हैं उसको. मोस्टली बुक्स में या न्यूमेरिकल्स में SOR, the SOR value is this much, ऐसे लिखा रहता है. तो SOR is nothing but the surface overflow rate. Overflow rate का मीनिंग भी वही है, सर्फेस लोडिंग रेट मतलब भी वही है. यू हैव डिफरेंट नेम्स फॉर इट. नाउ ये जो हमने डिस्चार्ज अपॉन द सर्फेस एरिया बोला है ना, दिस इज नथिंग बट द सर्फेस ओवरफ्लो रेट. वही है, दैट इज लाइक यू सी हियर हाउ इज द आउटलेट अरेंज, मतलब ये जो आउटलेट जोन से यहाँ पे दिस इज अ चेम्बर और आउटलेट वियर इज प्रोवाइडेड, मतलब क्या था, जब पानी इधर सेटल हो जाएगा and then it will pass to the outlet zone, and yeah, outlet zone may be when it passes now, jab ye overflow hoega is outlet zone mein, and then it will pass through the spheres and the outlet chamber. The same is the case in the circular tank also, that is pani it will rise up to the top layer, top surface, and then from the outlet chambers disperse ho jayega when it overflows. The same thing happens here also. Matlab yahan pe pura settling process ho jane ke baad it will go to the outlet zone, and then from the outlet, yahan pe arrow dekho, arrow aise upwards dikhaya na, upwards ka meaning kya hai ki yahan pe jo hai outlet zone mein jo fresh the you know the good water will start rising, okay, and then it will then overflow through this what you can say, the weirs, that is mostly this, that is it is called the surface overflow rate, that is discharge upon area. This the value of this actually becomes same to this settling velocity only, but you don't take it as like you know meter per second वगैरह में उसको नहीं करते हैं. Surface overflow rate जो उसका definition है या उसका meaning है, that is amount of water, quantity of the water per unit surface area, okay, q upon a, quantity of the water per unit surface area, it is surface area. So usko jo uska naam diya hai uske according hi uska unit rakhte hai, that is meter cube upon meter square per second. Agar usko hum fir se divide karte hai meter per second leke aate hai, then uska naam jo hai wo rehta nahi hai, then it becomes the settling velocity. But many where you get the surface overflow rate ka value, so you have to know that the unit is meter cube per meter square per second, that is discharge upon the surface area. Okay, so because we know ki v zero, just v not zero, v o overflow rate na, to isliye isko v o likha hai, theek hai, because we know now that v s is actually nothing but v o, मतलब दोनों एक्चुअली तो है सेम ही, ओके, मतलब वैल्यूज उसके. सो फ्रॉम दिस नाउ यू कम टू नो कि अगर एरिया, दैट इज द सरफेस एरिया, सरफेस एरिया, अभी नॉर्मली हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं कि सेटलिंग ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स विल डिपेंड अपॉन डेप्थ, बराबर हम लोग ऐसा बोलेंगे ना कि डिस्टेंस अपॉन टाइम. तो जितना ज्यादा डिस्टेंस है, ओके, उतना ज्यादा यू नो दिस टाइम लगेगा पार्टिकल्स को कवर होने के लिए, बराबर. कम हम लोग ऐसे सोचेंगे ना कि अगर डिस्टेंस या फिर हाइट ऑफ द सेडिमेंटेशन टैंक कम है तो ज्यादा से ज्यादा पार्टिकल्स सेटल हो सकते हैं, लेकिन वही अगर हाइट ऑफ द टैंक ज्यादा है तो पार्टिकल्स वुड टेक टाइम टू सेटल डाउन, बट इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट इन दिस. डेप्थ तो है ही, बट इंस्टेड ऑफ द डेप्थ, when you talk about the design of the sedimentation tank, mostly the settling of the particles, humko kya chahiye ki zyada se zyada particles settle ho jana chahiye, barabar, mera flow velocity itna kam hona chahiye ki zyada se zyada particles jo hai wo settle down ho jaye, barabar. So actually the settling of the particles depend upon the surface area of the tank. How? So you see here q upon a, agar surface area zyada hai a, that is L into B. अगर सर्फेस एरिया ज्यादा है तो ओवरफ्लो रेट इज गोइंग टू गेट रेड्यूस, ओवरफ्लो रेट गोइंग टू गेट रेड्यूस इन द सेंस द सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी इज गोइंग टू गेट रेड्यूस्ड, बराबर. तो इसका मीनिंग क्या है कि इवन द पार्टिकल्स हैविंग वेरी लो सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी, ओके, हमको क्या चाहिए, द सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी, मतलब फटाफट पार्टिकल सेटल होना चाहिए, उनका सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी ज्यादा चाहिए सो दैट इनलेट से आउटलेट वाटर पहुंचने तक पार्टिकल सेटल डाउन हो जाए, ओके. देयर माइट बी फ्यू पार्टिकल्स जिनका सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी बहुत कम है, तो इतना धीरे धीरे सेटल होते जाएंगे कि पूरा डिस्टेंस कवर ही नहीं हो पाएगा इतने पार्ट में, एंड दे विल गेट इन टू द आउटलेट जोन और बाहर निकल जाएंगे, तो वो सेटल हो ही नहीं पाएंगे क्योंकि उनका सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी इतना कम था, ओके. तो मुझे क्या चाहिए कि भले ही सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी पार्टिकल्स का कम है, लेकिन मैं चाहती हूँ कि वो पार्टिकल्स जिसका सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी कम है वो भी सेटल डाउन हो जाए. तो उसके लिए मुझे क्या करने का है, इफ एट ऑल द सर्फेस एरिया ऑफ द टैंक इज इंक्रीज एल इंटू बी, ओवरफ्लो रेट डिक्रीजेस, velocity, that is settling velocity, also decreases. Iska meaning the even the particles having very low settling velocity, they also can settle down in this settling chamber. Okay, now just give me a minute.
Theoretically, for a particle with settling speed vs, okay, the vertical fall is going to be vs times t. Okay, if the velocity, settling velocity is vs and t is the time, so any particle if which is spending t time in the tank will have a vertical fall of h. Now, if this vertical fall h, say for a particle entering at any particular point, okay, if this vertical fall h is less than the total tank depth, then it may or may not get removed. However, if this h is higher than the total depth of the tank, that means the particle is going to have a vertical fall in that time which is more than the tank depth. So that is certainly going to hit the bottom. Okay. So that way we actually define a term which is called critical settling speed or critical settling velocity, which is defined as when the vertical fall h is just equal to the tank depth or settling basin depth h. Okay, so when h is basically this h is equal to capital H, so that time what we get velocity is known as Vc, which is again comes to Q by A, and which is equal to the surface overflow rate as discussed earlier. So basically, critical settling velocity of a particle is equal to the overflow rate of the tank. So if you want to remove a particular dia particle completely, we have to kind of see that its settling velocity is actually equal to the overflow rate. Now, for all particles which is having settling velocity greater than critical settling velocity, so as just we are saying, their vertical fall will actually be greater than equal to h, and all these particles will get removed, so we'll have a collection efficiency of 100%. Whereas for particles which has settling velocity lesser than the critical settling velocity, so for them h is going to be equal to less than h. Okay, the like vertical fall is going to be less than the tank height. So vertical fall being less than the tank height means it is not going to be removed 100%. How much it will be removed will depend on at what level the particle is entering. So if, let's say, h is less than the h, if particle is entering at this or higher points, they will get removed. But if it is entering this or lesser point, they will not get removed. Okay. Sorry, if it is entering below this, they will get removed. If it is entering higher than this, so particle entering here will have vertical fall only this much, so it is going to strike here and leave to the outlet zone. So typically what happens in a real system, a large gradation of particle sizes are observed in water, and entire range of particles having kind of different settling velocity should be considered when we try to study the removal or the efficiency of the particle. So again,
that was a very small part that basically in short terms it was shown. Ab ye jo critical settling velocity inhone naam diya hai, basically we don't have that term anywhere in the in your book. Like you shouldn't get confused with the what is the critical and then what is the settling velocity. You shouldn't get confused, isliye wo term hum avoid karte. Whereas critical settling velocity is nothing but maximum height cover karne ke liye, the smallest particle for covering the maximum height in the given detention period. Matlab kuch bhi karke wo settle ho jana chahiye. Okay, even the minimum settling velocity, matlab even the particle having the minimum settling velocity should get settle down covering the whole height of the tank. That is called the critical settling velocity. And फिर उसमें इसलिए बताया कि वो तो maximum, that is the critical point है ना, कि मतलब इतना इतने कम से कम velocity वाला particle ज्यादा से ज्यादा distance cover करके अगर settle हो रहा है, then obviously the other particles in the tank should have the velocity greater than that critical settling velocity. It is like that. Okay, so basically it was that term, but you must know that when we are talking about the settling velocity, or which is nothing but the overflow rate, right? As I told you, h by t is it nothing but the overflow rate. So ये हम लोग बोलते हैं कि maximum distance cover करता है, okay? And particles with a minimum velocity, okay? So then particles entering at lower distances also should get settled down, and when can they settle down? If they have the velocity greater than the velocity of the particle entering from the top edge height covering the maximum distance. Okay, it's like